ending Bob Garibaldi. That's a familiar name. This is the son. Daddy was the pitcher with the Giants. Gaston Green. So they've got frontline people returning the kicks. Gaston Green is the starting tailback. And Carlos Rivez, the younger brother of Fuad Rivez, will be kicking for Tennessee. Transferred to UT Knoxville from UT Chattanooga. And the game is on. The eighth meeting, and the ball is way back and out of the end zone, and there'll be no return. And the UCLA Bruins will open this way. Matt Stevens at quarterback, 6'1", 190. The running backs will be Gaston Green, 5'11", 190, sophomore. Mel Farr, yep, another son, 6-footer, 215, a sophomore. The wide receivers, and this is the dandy, Mike Sherrard, 185, 6'2", and Carl Durrell, the flanker, 6-footer, 190, a junior from San Diego. And here comes the Bruins to the ball. Over the ball at center, Joe Goble. And young Matt Stevens gets the call this week to start the ball game in place of David Norrie, who started last week. Stevens turns, takes the ball to the tailback, keeps it, looks down the middle, throws to his tight end, Derek Tunnell. And Tunnell pulls it down at about the 28-yard line. Tunnell is 6'5", 235, the man who just caught it. Robert Cox, a tackle, 260. Mike Hartmeyer, guard, at 265. Joe Goble, a center, at 260. Jim McCullough, the other guard, 260. And Russ Warnick, a tackle, 255. It'll be second down, call it two, for the UCLA Bruins as they throw on first down. And not many people expected that. Stevens gives to Green. Green caught in the backfield. Great diving tackle by number 59, Mark Povanik. And here's the defensive alignment by Tennessee. Three-man front. Robbie Scott, Fred Bennett, and Mark Povanik. The backers are Ty Robinson, Kelly Zeigler, Darren Miller, Dale Jones. The secondary is Terry McDaniel, Tommy Sims, Chris White, and Vic Peppers. And they've got some people hurt who will be playing later in the season. It is third down and about three now for UCLA. A loss of a yard on the last play, and it's a double tight end alignment for the Bruins. Tennessee stacks inside. Green slants off tackle, breaks into the clear, and he is long gone, TD UCLA. They caught Tennessee stunning in the middle. They split him outside. Gaston Green has great speed, and he flew 72 yards, and UCLA is on the board, and that will have some impact on the noise of 91,000 people. Now here is an All-American record setter, John Lee, 70 consecutive extra points in his career at UCLA. The kick is up and the kick is good. So it didn't take long. After 13 minutes and 39 seconds of the first quarter, the UCLA Bruins are out to a 7-0 lead.
On the bottom of your screen, number 81, Tunnell makes the key block on the sweep when the ball carrier starts wide, then he cuts back inside. As Keith already said, Tennessee was in a blitzing, gapping defense. Everybody was walled off. Gaston Green runs 72 yards. Here's the key block by number 81. His assignment is to sustain his block. Right there on the defensive end, Robinson. Get up in him, stay with him, keep your feet going. Just a good block, and finally turn him to the outside, and Green cuts inside for the touchdown.
Once he broke into the clear, there was nobody around going to run him down, because once he broke into the clear, he did it so suddenly, he was 10 yards out and gone.
Gaston Green had a great finishing season last year, 144 yards in the game against Miami in the Fiesta Bowl. He 72-yard touchdown run there also.
BYU played him wide last week, forced everything into the middle on the ground, and he didn't get a whole lot, but he certainly improved his stats so far. This is a kickoff. Jim Bray kicked seven times last week. None were returned, but his first one today will be. It is Pete Fanuska, who brings the football back to about the 19-yard line. And Tennessee will open this way with Tony Robinson, 6'3", 185, a senior, over 2,000 yards a year ago. Charles Wilson, a 205-pound sophomore, is the tailback. And Big Sam Henderson, 250-pound fullback. the white people, Tim McGee, the leading receiver, 5'10", 180. Eric Swanson, 5'11", and 185, the split in. But we'll see a variety of wide receiver people today, including, as I said a few minutes ago in the pregame program, Sam Grady, the silver medalist at 100 meters in the Olympic Games. All right, Robinson back. And he's going to throw on the first play of the ball game, and he's got a man wide open. It is Tim McGee. First down, Tennessee at the 49.
What a great execution on the first play. McGee going in motion. He's going to go down, and then he breaks to the outside in behind the front cover. He's wide open. Robinson lays the ball out there perfectly. A beautiful catch by McGee, who had 54 receptions last year. Johnny Major says, Keith, he's the best receiver they've had at Tennessee.
That's big words. The ball is just short of midfield with Panuska lined up at the tailback position instead of Wilson. They send McGee in motion and give the ball to the up man, the big back, 250-pounder. And Sam Henderson from South Bend, Indiana, hammers in there for about five. Jeff Smith, tight end, 6'3", 235. David Douglas, 265 at tackle. Galbraith weighs 260 at guard. The center is 255, Kirk. John Bruin, 275 at guard. Bruce Wilkinson, 260 at tackle. And there's only one senior along that offensive front amongst the big guys from tackle to tackle. Charles Wilson now is back in at tailback for Tennessee on second down and five. Robinson, little quick pop. They've got him set up on a screen over there. It is Joey Clinkscale. And Clinkscales gets to Tennessee first down and snaps the ball in frustration. He thought he could have gone all the way. They'll put him down at the 24-yard line.
This is something Tennessee likes to use, a flanker screen. Fake away from the top of your screen. Get the defense moving this way, then throw the ball right out on the line of scrimmage, picking up the block from the lineman. A good wall of blockers, and number 87, Clinkscale, is mad because he tripped.
Volunteers trying to enter UCLA's opening burst. Bruins out on top 7-0 on a 72-yard run by Gaston Green. First down, Tennessee, UCLA 24. And here goes Wilson, the tailback. And he slashes over the right side and picks up 9 yards. And the ball's rolling around loose. And UCLA's got it. So Wilson, a big hole over the right side. But he was hit late. The ball came loose and looked like Mark Whalen covered it.
Often when a ball carrier is fighting for extra yards, the ball pops out. You can see that Wilson puts his hand on the ground and doesn't protect the ball. It pops out. UCLA recovers. We'll be right back.
Temple Owls told you last week they were going to be a pretty good football team. They're making a game of it with Penn State. Right now, the UCLA Bruins with Tennessee turning it over at UCLA's 15. Bruins will take it there and go the other way. They scored quickly the first time they had it. Stevens fakes the ball to the tailback. Goes deep down the middle for Sherrard. It is incomplete. Double coverage, and the Bruins are lucky to get that one back.
As we can see, Sherrard, number 82, is going to go deep inside. The quarterback was trying to look number 7, the safety man, away from the play. But White, a senior, was not to be denied. He came across and made the play along with the right halfback. Davis, the starting free safety, is injured. White is playing for really the first time. The only time he's played is on special teams.
So Homer Smith has planted that seed in the mind of the Tennessee defenders now. And Stevens gives the ball to Green, and Green is hauled down. As he tries to cut back against the grain, and they get him at about the 18-yard line. Terry Donahue, at age 32, succeeded Dick Vermeil. And if he wins this game today, as we told you, he becomes the all-time winning coach at UCLA with 73 wins. Third down at about 7. Tennessee defenders jumping around. Stevens back to throw. Looks and goes on the ground. Pass intended for Sherrard. He was getting some pressure. And when he let it go, he had to hurry the throw. And it was incomplete. Temple gets now to within 2 of Penn State on a safety. Now the Bruins will kick, and Ted Henderson, a redshirt senior from Albuquerque, had a very good ball game last week in the mountain air of the Wasatch Mountains of Utah, averaging over 42 yards per kick. The deep man is Tim McGee for Tennessee.
Tim McGee's a flower.
Balls go after him. He gets the kick away. Ball hangs, and McGee comes up on the fair catch and receives the ball just inside the UCLA 48-yard line. So the Volunteers get it back in field position. Completion percentage mark last year in his junior year. Now he's got some field position to start from. UCLA is close to the 47. They seemed to be on their way a while ago in the first possession until Wilson fumbled the ball. They threw on first down in the first snap, and they run it this time. Go right back to Wilson to give him a little confidence, and he's going to pick up 3-4 yards on the carry.
Terry Taylor, second leading tackler, number 42 for UCLA, plays that middle linebacker position mostly. All he has to do is watch the tailback and try to move over and whip the blocker on this one. Makes an outstanding play and gets some help from Chucky Miller, number 37.
He's from Chattanooga.
Chattanooga, Tennessee.
Who went west, and he says sometimes he goes home to Chattanooga and he thinks people work hard at ignoring him. But he's a good football player.
He's a very good football player, Keith.
Second down and six, and Robinson back to throw, has all day, and he throws the ball wide of his mark. Wilson, the tailback, coming out of the backfield, was there, but Robinson didn't get him. Defensively for UCLA, the three big guys down are Batchkoff, Toomey, and Whalen. Jackson, Smith, Jarecki, and Taylor, the backers. And the secondary, Miller, Henley, Rutledge, and Washington. And you will hear Washington's name before the day is over. He's a good one.
Washington's just a sophomore, but as a freshman, Keith, he led the team in tackles from his safety position.
It is third and six now for Tennessee. Ball on the UCLA 44. Robinson kept it on an option, and good defensive play as he is stopped by Eric Smith for little gain. Now let's join Jim Lampley.
We have to go home to bed early tonight.
Well, here is Bob Garman now entering as Tennessee's punter, succeeding Jimmy Colquitt. And he spins it up into the air, and it's a tail dragger and kicks right on into the end zone, and so the ball will come back out to about to the 20-yard line. It's a 43-yard punt. Maryland came on late in the ball game to rumble over Boston College. So the Eagles now are 0-2. And up at Morgantown, West Virginia leading Duke by 8.
Keith, we can expect from UCLA power running plays and play action passes most of the time. They believe in trying to control that football in that manner.
Marcus Greenwood is in at fullback now, replacing Mel Farr. He had a big game at BYU, picked up more than 70 yards. They go back to the tailback, Green, and Green is nailed down after a 1-yard pickup at the 21-yard line. We've got 9:15 to play in the first quarter, and the Bruins leading 7-0 over Tennessee. Michigan State now still holding on to their lead, and Auburn begins to stretch it out a bit at halftime over Southern Miss. What was it you said Barnhill used to tell you about scoring so many points early?
In that first ball game, he said, Frank, don't score so many. Save them. You're going to need them down the way. And he was right, too. He scored 60 points in one game and 7 the second game.
Don't let him think scoring is easy.
That's right. Don't let him think he can get scores anytime he wants to. They're hard to come by in a tough game.
Second down and 9. Matt Stevens back to throw. Goes to the man out of the backfield. That's the fullback, Marcus Greenwood. And Greenwood takes a lick right at the marker. He's close to the first down.
Good execution on the part of Stevens. He wanted to go deep on the play-action fake, but Greenwood is the layoff man out in the flat in case he cannot go to the end deep for the first down. And a good quick snap release by Stevens right into the hands of Greenwood. Good tackle coming up, number 8, Peppers.
Just short of the first down. I think that's an example, though, of why Stevens probably going to be the quarterback of UCLA. He is quick, he reads quickly, and he makes quick decisions.
Perfect, Keith. That's
quarterback sneak, diving for the first down, and they're going to give it to him just over the 30.
That is so important, what you mentioned, the quick decisions. you have just a second to identify the defense off that play action pass, and you've got to get the ball to the open receiver. Stevens was very impressive in the Brigham Young last week in the second half.
Tennessee hurrying to get a new defender into the ball game, and will probably change the defense a little bit as UCLA comes up now on first down just over the 30-yard line, leading 7-0 in the first quarter. And Stevens still got it, rolls it out now and whips it to the sidelines, and the pass is complete to Carl Durrell, 6-footer, 190. He was on the sidelines and going right on out of bounds. He had no place to go. But again, you see the quick release and strong arm of Stevens. Next week, these are the possibilities here on ABC. Notre Dame, Michigan State at South Bend, or South Carolina hosting Michigan. And what swings that is the outcome of the Notre Dame-Michigan game up in Ann Arbor. It's second down and two for UCLA. Pick data on that last play. Tailback, Green, outside he goes. Gets the first down. Oh, boy. Boy, you're not going to arm tackle him, I'll tell you right now. And he ran right through two arms on that play.
Let's go back and talk a little bit about Curtis Green. He was just a freshman last year, went into the Southern Cal game, made 130, rushed for 134 yards, came into the Fiesta Bowl and rushed for 144 yards. Today, he has 83 yards and 5 carries.
One of them, of course, a 72-yard sprint for a touchdown against Green. First down, Bruins. Ball just over the 45.
Going on first down.
Down the line comes Stevens. Pitches the ball back to Green. Green drops it. Scramble for it. Tennessee looks like they've got it. They do. Number 96. Tyrone Robinson comes out with it.
Fundamental mistake on Green's part. The lateral was being pitched to him, and he looked at the defense, took his eyes off the ball, fumbled it. Tennessee got it back, and a break for them.
Three to go in the first quarter. UCLA has now turned it over, and Tennessee has the ball. First down at the Bruins 45. 7-0. Bruins lead. Robinson, the quarterback. Howard in at fullback. Another big 225. Spread them out, move them around. That's what they're trying to do to UCLA, and give the ball to Howard coming off injury. His first action, really, of the fall. Again, let's go to Jim.
Up in Ann Arbor, Michigan, Keith, the Michigan Wolverines had temporarily taken the lead over Notre Dame on a Harbaugh run. It was 10-9 at that point, but now Carney has come back with his fourth field goal of the game, and for the moment, still in the third quarter, it is the Irish 12 and Michigan 10. Back to Knoxville.
Well, that sounds exciting.
Keith, look how wide the receivers are. You can see how Tennessee spreads the defense from sideline to sideline.
Back goes Robinson to throw, swings it out. Wilson's got it, slips and falls at the 40. He had his first down, I think, or close to it, but he lost his footing when he tried to make the cut on the inside.
Well, look at here.
Wes, Steve Sloan says he's got a much better team this year. It's going to be tougher at Duke.
And there's your final score, with Michigan State winning and Air Force and Wyoming now. The Wyoming Wishbone getting the lead there. Delaware is leading Navy. And old Tubby got the
Tubby Raymond.
Mud hens working here. What do they call them? Mud hens.
Mud hens, that's correct.
Robinson gives the ball to Wilson. The tailback, and he squirts through there. They'll need one more yard for the first down. They were at 3rd and 5. Now they're looking at 4th and 1.
And all the players are saying, let's go for it. All the stands are yelling, let's go for it. But be careful, Majors. I'm telling you, you don't make it, you're the bum. But I believe they're going to go for
it. Yeah, he's ending Henderson, number 43, the 250-pound fullback, comes into the ball game, and they're going to go on 4th down. And you know what? It's at least it's a good yard and a half.
At least. You're right. A good yard and a half.
Line up tight inside to set up a power hour situation. And give it to the big man, the fullback, and he did not make it. Sam Henderson did not make the first down.
Nowhere near, wasn't close, Keith. UCLA got right under the blockers. The key to stopping short yardage, see if we can tell the defensive lineman, getting underneath. The key man is over to the left. Batchkoff gets the penetration, then 41 Miller comes in, fills a hole right there. Beautiful.
Kenny Norton.
Kenny Norton, 41. Kenny Norton. Great play on their part.
Johnny Majors in Tennessee takes a gamble. Bruins turned it away, and UCLA gets the ball back at their own 36. Tennessee offense opened strong, seemed to be on their way for a touchdown, but they've had it twice since, and the offense is, the movement of the ball by the Tennessee offense is getting shorter and shorter. Now UCLA takes over at the 36, and Eric Ball in the backfield as Stevens comes down on the option, throws to Mike Sherrard, and completes to Mike up around the 45-yard line. Eric Ball, the tailback, 6'1", 215, a redshirt freshman from Ypsilanti, Michigan.
Sherrard runs a better than the 4-4 in the 40. He is caught in 25. This makes the 25th straight game he's caught two or more passes. Just a consistent performer. And Keith, surprisingly, he was a walk-on.
Yeah, remember, we saw him in the UCLA-Georgia game about 3 years ago, and he had a big ball game in Athens, though they lost the game. And he's been very, very consistent to change across the field to see whether or not they have the first, and they do not. Time remaining, 4-5-4, first quarter. Tennessee has not been terribly successful over the last 7 years in their home openers, in the main because they have gone out and stuck their head out there in the opening game against tough people. They're only 1 out of 7.
But Keith, look at what Tennessee's got faced them after this game. They've got number 2 ranked Auburn. They've got Alabama, and they got number 3 ranked Florida in the next 4 weeks. So they, a win today would give them a big boost. They've got some tough games ahead of them.
It's second down and about a foot. Quarterback Stevens has the first down. Surge on the right side behind McCullough and Warnick. And he had plenty of room. He moved it out to the 47, rather. Washington BYU underway, and the Cougars, as usual, get on top. Washington doesn't get out of easy after this one either. The Huskies have to go to Houston and play Houston down there.
It'll be 3 games in a row on the road for them.
Yep. This is Ball. And Ball just accepts the ball and goes straight ahead and gets to midfield as we again go to Jim.
This at Morgantown, West Virginia, a surprisingly rough.
And second down, 8. 7.5, if you like. From midfield for UCLA, Stevens to throw. Whips it over to the number 81, Tennell, making his second catch of the ball game. The tight end drifting to the sidelines, and he makes the catch down at the Tennessee 41.
Tennell, the tight end, caught 23 passes last year. He was a fullback in high school, has 4-5 speed, and when you have that kind of receiver at tight end, you want to get him across, working on the linebackers. He just, there's a mismatch there. He's wide open for the completion.
Matt Stevens now has hit 4 in a row. He's 5 out of 7 for 45 yards. The scoring burst was a 72-yard run by Gaston Green. 7-0 UCLA, and they're now beginning to mount another threat. As Stevens rolls it out, throws to the sidelines. The pass is caught by Mike Sherrard. He's thrown out of bounds. They've got another first down at the Tennessee 26-yard line.
Beautiful signal calling is by the UCLA staff. Sherrard, number 82, outstanding. The coaches say that he runs such precise routes. He has the speed and all of that, but he just sets up the defenders where they have no idea where he's going. That's a perfect example of how open he can be in the secondary.
Mel Farr comes back in at fullback now. Ball down at the 26. The crowd trying to get into the act a little bit, make some noise for Stevens and company. Give it a ball. Ball goes over. Fumble. Around, did it get out of bounds? I think it went out of bounds. Yeah, a couple of orange shirts over there, but they couldn't get a handle on it.
Ball number 21 is going to get a trying to run over his own blocker far, and the ball just pops out. If the offensive team has possession of the ball, if it's not, doesn't make a difference who touches it.
And the Bruins now call a timeout. The loss on the play takes them back to the 28-yard line. They'll be looking at second down and 12 with 3 minutes and 16 seconds to play in the first quarter, leading 7-0. But when you get this close to the goal line, anywhere inside of a 50-yard field goal, and perhaps even beyond it, they become still a scoring possibility with John Lee's.
This is his opportunity. Last week, he was our relief quarterback and did a nice job coming in off the bench against BYU. And I'm going to switch the roles of the two players this week and let Matt get the starting call. And if the team doesn't move or doesn't generate enough yardage or points for whatever reason, I'm going to go to David Norrie, who started last week, and ask him to come off the bench and try to generate the offense.
Right now, Stevens is doing just fine. Green is back in at tailback. Here's the blitz. And Stevens throws it away. That could get you a flag, couldn't it?
Yes, it could. Official did not call it. Very questionable.
There was not a white shirt within 18 yards of the ball.
Quarterback was retreating, Stevens, when he threw the ball, and he couldn't get enough velocity behind it to get it close to the receiver. I'm sure that's what the official interpreted.
Got a mixed crew. You got four SEC and three Pac-10. LSU pulled it out against North Carolina, 23-13. They were tied at 13 apiece late in the third quarter. Third down and 12 now. Blitz again, Keith. Went to a long count. They pick him up pretty well. Stevens now can't find anybody. Pulls it down and takes off. And is ridden out of bounds about the 22. And so the Tennessee defense stands up pretty well under that pressure as Dale Jones made the stop. And here comes Mr. Lee.
What a story Mr. Lee is too, Keith. Unbelievable accuracy. Something like 81% for his career.
Well, inside 40, he is 42 out of 43. The tee is put down at the 29, so he's inside 40. 39-yard try. The holder is David Clinton. The snapper is Terry Theodore. Theodore has snapped the ball on every one of his kicks during Lee's career, and it's plenty of leg, and it's down the pipe. I mean, just nailed it right down the middle. John doesn't worry a whole lot about the wind and Kentucky windage and all those kind of things. He says, I just hit it as hard as I can right down the middle. And most of the time, the ball has perfect end-over-end action. He is quite remarkable. So he has given UCLA a 10-0 lead.
He's had tremendous success even since he was a freshman. He had unbelievable numbers in his freshman year and has continued to improve, if that be possible.
Well, he's almost certain to finish as the most accurate kicker in NCAA history. Looking at other scores, and as Jim told you a while ago, West Virginia Duke is now final. First month of the season, always rife with upsets.
So much uncertainty when you coaches start this season, Keith. There's so much parity in college football today. Someone was telling me that the seven games is the longest winning streak in college today, and only four other teams have four games in a winning streak, and everybody else is less than four all over the country. That's parity.
Jim Bray is out to kick off. Hits this one a little harder and hooks it toward the corner of the end zone, and there will be no return on this one. As Beniska watched it, I think Pete probably thought it was going to go out of bounds, but it held the line. And it'll come back to the 20. He kicked that into the wind. When he gets it with the wind, I don't believe that Tennessee will have a chance to return.
It's a big advantage to have a place kicker that after you score, kicks the ball over the goal line.
What do you think about some people are talking about putting the ball on the 35?
I don't know why we don't, Keith. I've advocated that for years and years and years, and for some reason, we're reluctant to do it. I think we don't want to copy the pros. But we should do it, in my judgment. I think we will.
From the 20, here come the Volunteers, down 10-0 with Howard and Wilson lined up and Robinson to throw. There's some of his quickness and agility. His pass is away now, and the pass is complete. And it's good up to the 34-yard line. Jeff Smith, the tight end, showed you some moves right there.
Well, Jeff Smith caught 26 passes last year. He's vital, key, important in this passing game of Tennessee, but this is what Robinson does so well. He's quick, can run, throw on the run, find the receiver. This took a perfect throw, Keith. Mm-hmm. I mean, a perfect throw for the reception. Smith pulls it in.
14-yard pickup, first down, Vols, their own 34. Robinson looking to throw again. Going deep. Pass intended for McGee, defended by Chucky Miller. Heck of a play by Miller. Miller is 5'9", and McGee 5'10", so their size was relative.
Well, McGee runs faster than a 4-4 in the 40, but it's perfectly played by 37 Miller, running step for step with him. Now they look up for the ball together, and it's important is who gets the leap, who can jump the highest. Miller adjusting to the ball and gets his hands up. Let's see.
Just enough.
And just enough to deflect it out of the reach of McGee.
And it's second down and 10.
That was a good example of Robinson's strong arm, Keith.
Pretty good foot race, wasn't it?
It was.
Going to throw again. Now he starts rolling around, pulls it down, and gets it up to the 39-yard line.
Boy, he's dangerous, Keith. When he gets that ball and you scramble out of it, you have a distorted coverage in your secondary. It's key to really stay in your position for the defense when he starts scrambling or somebody be open for a touchdown. Here comes the dime backfield, defensive backfield for the UCLA Bruins.
Get
the number so far.
Backs.
Yeah, six defensive backs. Four rushes, one linebacker.
Ball on the 39. It is third down and 5.
Tennessee continues to assault with formations.
Well, it looked like they had in mind trying to split him up the middle, and William Howard ran into Terry Toomey, and Toomey just was staying at home, and nobody moved him around, and he made the stop.
That situation is when you out-coach yourself. Let the quarterback use the audible, and he had a pass called. He saw a certain defense. He tried to change off to the run, and it didn't work.
Garmin in the punt, first one today, was good for 43. He's got a little help with the wind. Get some spin on it. Comes drifting back to Gifford Urban. And a penalty flag is down as Urban goes down at the 19. 41-yard punt, no return. Let's see about the flag. The referee is Dick Burleson.
Keith, as they discussed, oh, go ahead with officials.
Yeah, they can read them. You go ahead.
Okay, well, Tennessee has always excelled in the kicking game, particularly Bob Nalen started that. He believed that games were won and lost in the kicking game. Every Tennessee coach that's been here has stressed, emphasized an excellent kicking game.
Cliff Bruins.
Goes back to the spot that hurts you the most. They penalize it from right there.
So the Bruins are going to stop deep in their own territory this time as we go to Jim again. I wonder how the golf courses are in South Carolina.
Here's Johnny, it's Terry Donahue. What a fine football coach he is. Low key, there's his winning record, 70%. Last 5 years, something like 75%. Two big Rose Bowl wins.
I remember him when he walked on at UCLA.
Just a little old guard, wasn't he, Keith?
No, he played defensive tackle on Tommy Prothro's team. Yeah.
How much did he weigh? 190?
Well, he used to lie.
I think he weighed about 187 pounds, 88 pounds.
I've known him a long time, and I like him. He's a fine man.
He's a strong communicator. Motivates his team by as well as anybody we have in the game today. A little mad at those officials about something.
9-yard line. First down, Bruins. Crowd getting into it. Ball goes to Gaston Green. Good run by Green up to close to the 17-yard line. So that's about 8 for him.
Another good blocking by that UCLA line, particularly on that right side. They've done an excellent job. That's where they scored their touchdown. Jim McCullough, the leading blocker for the team, number 77, and Russ Warwick, just a sophomore, but great potential.
Bruins play selection so far in the game. 12 runs, 9 passes. Double tight end, second down, 2.
That's impressive, Keith, the balance between running and passing.
Tailback's got it. Green's got the first down as he changes directions twice on that short run and moves the ball out to the 22. That fellow there on the right with a towel around him, that's Norm Anderson. He is the man who principally sends the plays in. Norm was a wide receiver at UCLA in his playing days.
Well, Keith, we've got some excellent wide receivers on both teams, not just the two All-American prospects in Sherrod and McGee. But they are balanced across there with talent, skilled people, both teams.
First down and 10 from the 22. Whistle stops him. And the quarter is over. The 22, Stevens pitches to Green. Gaston Green is stripped up and goes out to about the 26. That'll be a 4-yard pickup.
Well, Keith, those stats just reflect good offensive performance and execution. Good running with the football, 104 yards. And there's Gaston Green's record so far. But mixing up the passes, 6 out of 9 for Stevens. That's impressive. Way he's kept the defense off balance of Tennessee.
Second and 6. Roll back on his way. Belfar rambles all the way to the 43-yard line before Terry McDaniel brings him down.
McCullough, the right guard, and the center, Goble, make good blocks. Favre just has a gaping hole, has nowhere to go but right down the middle, north and south. Finally, the safety man brings him down.
James Primus is now in, a sophomore out of National City, 190 pounds, a tailback. Another very promising youngster. And Stevens makes it to him, and is sacked, and the ball rolls loose, and the Tennessee man covers it, but they call him down. Back at the 33-34. That time the blitz got home.
That's what Tennessee needs to do, is get some penetration on these play-action passes. Quarterback has to hold the ball quite a while, and the receivers have not gotten open. You can, I believe it was
That's a good call.
Good call. Stevens' knee was down while he had possession of the ball. The play is over, even though he later fumbled.
I think his whole body was down.
All right, let's see. No, close. The ball the ball was kicked out as he was waving it. Tough call against Tennessee.
Second down. They've got to go to the Tennessee 47 roughly to get the first down. This snap is from about the 34. They're on a draw, and carrying is Primus, and Primus is maybe 38-yard line. Another look at it. Looks to me like his leg's down.
All right, it seems to me that the ball hops
out.
It
might have.
Yeah, it seems like they knocked it out just before his knee touched the ground. Fisher was screened off from it. Fisher is over to the right. He cannot see it. It's number 99, Anthony Howard, I believe, knocks the ball out with his right hand.
It is third down, UCLA and 14.
Stevens is in the shotgun. Yep.
Let's it go, and it is incomplete. The pass receiver, Willie Anderson, turned inside. The ball was thrown outside. That is fourth down, and the Bruins now will punt.
Tennessee got some rush on the pass, and that's a key to any pass defense success. Put some pressure, make the quarterback throw earlier than he wants to before your defense is spread thin in the secondary.
McGee, the deep man, dangerous with Henderson to the punt. His first kick today was good for 30 yards into the wind. Now he's got the wind at his back. Kind of swirls around in this big oval, and he gets a dandy. McGee gets a good block and comes back to the 20. Otherwise, Nick Tim is spread all over the landscape. That was a 44-yard punt and a 4-yard return tackled by Mark. Volunteers need to get some points on the board. They have the ball first down at their own 20, trailing 10-0 with 12:14 to go in the first half. Opening game for Tennessee, second game for UCLA. Charles Wilson and Keith Davis line up in the backfield. No real fullback in there right now, and Tony Robinson rolls it out with a guardian. Throws it to the sidelines. The pass is caught by Charles Wilson, and Wilson is short of his first down, just over the 28. Again, Jim.
Well, Napoleon McCallum got over 100 in the first half.
Robinson rolls out, runs away from the pursuit, gets his pass away, hits him on the numbers. Look out. This is Tim McGee, and he is finally run down on the UCLA 41.
What a fantastic play. There's no reason away. It busted in the backfield first, and then you can see Robinson has that great knack of finding the open receiver when he's scrambling, and McGee is excited. What a great receiver. McGee runs in motion, turns down, and soon as he sees the scramble by Robinson, go to the open spot. Come on inside. Find the opening. Right there. Now put on the dance, and there he goes.
Two catches for McGee, 61 yards, first down Tennessee, Bruin 41. Howard, the lone back, and now they shuffle things around with Keith Davis going to the tailback slot, and Davis has it. Puts his helmet down and rams against Mark Whalen and gets something out of it. Davis at 190, running into a 250-pounder from Burlingame, California. Tony Robinson, over 100 yards in his passing. I don't know if I've seen a quarterback recently that has a... I mean, he was moving, and the pass was just letter perfect.
And moving to his left, Keith, which you pointed out, and which is a difficult to throw, moving to your left and throw across your body right on the numbers.
Second down and 7, and Robinson back to throw. As protection, has a man short of the first down. Good tackle by Rutledge. Craig Rutledge really laid a hit on Jeff Smith and kept him from picking up the first down. He'll be about a yard short of it.
Rutledge, number 30, intercepted the first quarter pass, Brigham Young, last week for a touchdown.
He had arthroscopic knee surgery about 2.5 weeks ago, too.
Here the numbers.
3.5 weeks ago now.
Here, that arthroscopic surgery is something else, Keith. It's the greatest invention of all, as far as athletics is concerned. But Jeff Smith, the tight end, is a key man.
Third down and about a yard.
Ran all over the field.
Last time they went on a short yardage play, they gave it to the fullback. This time, they didn't make it again. Charles Wilson, the tailback, took it that time, and they didn't make it as Mark Whalen, defensive right side tackle, just nailed him down.
Well, Keith, when you spread everybody all over the field and the defense do not move out with you, you can't run the ball. The numbers game catches. They got more players on defense at the point of attack than you do offense.
Johnny Majors wants a timeout to talk to his team about what to do. I guess he's got in mind that he's going to go for
he's
it.
Gonna go
he's
going
to be
Keith.
Looking at fourth down and about 2 yards with 9:42 to go in the half and trailing. Is yet to convert on either third down or fourth down in 5 tries in the ball game. And they're going to go on 4th and 2 here. The ball at the UCLA 33.
Keith, when you run on 4th and 1 like they did earlier and 3rd and 2 and don't make it, then you usually line up and try some play-action pass.
They're in a power eye. I think they're going to run.
Oh, play-action pass.
That play-action pass. Got it. It was Jeff Smith that pulled it down.
That's the key. You go with your best horses. Your best player is your quarterback, and the fake in the backfield is really the key that sets it up. 81 just goes to the ground just like he's a blocker. Smith, number 81. Now he jumps up. The linebackers have forgotten him. Good play acting. That's the key. You got to fool those people sometimes like them. I had one of those or two in my time. Chuck doesn't think so, but I did.
First and 10 from the UCLA 27. Davis is the tailback. Howard, the fullback. Robinson swings it out to Davis. One-hand catch. He got a block that popped him loose there. Number 75 came across, John Bruin, and laid the block for him, and he made something out of the play when it looked like he was going to take a lick for a loss.
Well, this Tennessee offense is based a lot on Bill Walsh of San Francisco. Here's the Volunteers' possessions. 2 plays fumble, 4 plays punt, 4 plays lost on downs, 5 plays and a punt, and here we are in their 5th possession threatening.
Robinson now 9 of 11, 125 yards.
Stay with that quarterback. He looks sensational.
Second down 6 from the 23. Wings it over there in a hurry, and gets short yardage out of it. Coming up quickly to make the tackle on Joey Klinkscales is Darrell Hindley, and the pass is ruled incomplete. I guess he lost it going down.
That's a situation where the blitz by UCLA was on, and Robinson makes Keith a slight adjustment. I'm not sure those are the best thing to do. He just raises up and throws the ball regardless of what he had called in the huddle, and it was very close to being intercepted by Hindley, number two. He sets it back.
Goal. Third down at about six now for Tennessee.
The blitz scared them out of running. The threat of the blitz scared Tennessee out of their play.
Wilson is back in. McGee goes in motion. Here's the blitz. And he got it. Number 40, Toomey, coming out of the nose guard position, makes the hit on him. And the loss is back beyond the 30 to about the 32.
One thing you worry about in this part of the field, you expect the blitz, a twist. Toomey lines up on the left and comes all the way around the other man, number 95, Whalen, and makes the play. The twist is difficult to pick up with this Tennessee offense, Keith, because they block right at the line of scrimmage. They don't retreat on their pass block.
Carlos Rivez is in, and he gets a considerable challenge in his first try as a volunteer. It's a 49-yard try. He got it.
How about that? In your first try.
So the younger brother comes through from 49 yards. Tennessee's on the board at 10-3. Garibaldi and Green go deep for UCLA as Tennessee scores the 49-yard field goal off the foot of Rivez, and it's a 10-3 ball game, and Carlos will kick off now. High kick into the wind. Goal line, Green. Out to the 25. Brought down by Darren Miller. Now the old pendulum swings. It looked like UCLA was going to take control of the ball game for a time. The Tennessee defense took some chances, got their back up, made some big plays. And now the offense came in and produced some points. And the defense had some time to rest. It is quite cool today, however. And let's see what the strategy is at this point. Defense jumping around, show a four-man front right now with four backers. They literally are lined up in a 4-4-3.
Oldest defense in football, Keith.
And the ball is given off to the tailback, James Primus. And Primus powers over the left side and gets up to about the 27.
Here's the offensive yard by UCLA, 122 and 60. Just the reverse by Tennessee. Tennessee is primarily a passing team. Cannot be a very effective running the ball if UCLA continues to blitz.
Second down and eight. Goes back to the weak side man, and the ball is caught at the 31. The crowd hoots. They thought it bounced in there. Ruled good catch again, Jim.
They called that an incomplete pass after all, didn't they?
Yes, the umpire has that call. The man inside on any pass, whether it's trapped or not, and he ruled it incomplete.
So it's third and eight.
Here's the blitz.
He gets it off and just before the blitz, but he is short of the first down. That's a good defensive play on Carl Durrell. There were two men coming. That's one of the things that we were told about the Tennessee defensive people. They may not have much experience yet, but they can run to the ball.
That's a great point. The thing that you do in pass defense, give them the short pass, but don't let them make anything running after the catch it. And Durrell caught that ball 3 yards from the first down. He didn't make another inch. Not another inch. Two Tennessee men hit him, as Keith said.
Tim McGee deep. Henderson to punt. High kick. McGee drifts under it. Fair catches it.
Foul kick, Keith, because the covering team cannot run within 2 yards of the safety man, once the ball is on its downward flight, it's a 5-yard penalty.
Marcus Turner was a man that ran close to him, 41-yard punt. And looks like they'll mark off 5 yards against the Bruins. 6:01 to go, first half. The 5-yard penalty puts the football out at the 33 for Tennessee, and so Tony Robinson and the company get pretty good field position for this possession. Robinson is out of Tallahassee. Tallahassee? What are you doing, Bobby?
Well, he wanted to play on a team like Tennessee. This type of offense. Yeah.
Great history here.
Said he wanted to go away from home.
Robinson quickly delivers the ball. The ball is caught by Kent Scales, and Joey is up for about a 5-yard pickup near the 38-yard line.
Keith, both teams have seemed to be having some success with the blitz because I think both offensive lines are inexperienced. Tennessee's going to go without a huddle. They plan to do this some in this ball game.
Got to cooperate with them a little over.
Well, the value of this, the defense cannot call sometimes what they want to.
Little sideline pattern again. It's good. Close to the first down. Good to Eric Swanson. Where'd they put him out? At the 44. And I believe that'll be a first down.
You don't huddle. Your defense cannot get called all the stunts, Keith, that they want to, the blitzes. They have to play pretty much a basic defense.
Chains aren't set, though. They can't go till the chains are set. Now they can go. Same stuff. Swanson to the UCLA 49.
Robinson is just reading the defensive coverage. UCLA is lining up in a basic defense with a no huddle.
He got a bad spot there, Frank.
He sure did. lost about a yard, didn't he?
He did.
Here again, you'll see the audible at the line of scrimmage, Keith, by Robinson calling the play out right and left. That's a change of defense by UCLA.
But he's taking them out of the blitz.
Loops it this time for Swanson and a little bit too long. Swanson had wiggled around and gotten behind Chucky Miller. And Robinson's pass was just a little long for Swanson.
Chucky Miller disrupted the pattern of the wide receiver Swanson. Otherwise, I believe it had been completed. Miller saw he's going to get beat, and he just used his hands legally and disrupted the pattern. Timing was off. That's a good way to play pass defense. You can't cover him, disrupt his pattern, Keith.
He's lost another half a yard on the spot this time. They've now got the ball all the way back to the midfield, but it really ought to be up on the 49. They're 0 for 5 on third down conversions. Robinson takes off up the middle. He's got room. He's got a first down. He's out of bounds inside the 40 at the 39. He's 6'3", but at least... Well, it looks like 5 of those 6'3 are legs. I mean, he is really a long-legged kid.
Keith, he has that quickness, that vision, and he's a great competitor. The coaches told me that when he runs into adversity, it doesn't bother him at all. And as soon as he saw the hole opening up, he just ran for the first down. Quarterback like that, receivers all covered, he makes the first down. That's the reason he was so successful last year, his first year as a starter. Quarterbacks using audibles really every time.
They hit him, he gets the ball off, and it is incomplete, and a great effort on the catch downfield. But Tim McGee couldn't pull it down between James Washington and Darrell Henley.
Two pretty good defensive players there. Washington's safety man is going to come over. It looks like he's going to maybe knock the ball loose from McGee, but the play was just perfectly thrown. Robinson knew he was going to take a shot. He stayed in there and threw the ball just perfectly. Could have been completed. Just a great throw, great touch. Outstanding touch. Boy, he's exciting. Robinson is just can make the big play for you, Keith.
Second and 10. Dump it off. Wilson's got two men in front of him.
Got a first down inside the 20. Penalty flag. Got a face mask, I believe, down around the 15-yard line.
What a beautiful call by the Tennessee State. First time they've shown the screen to the back. How do you fight the rush? What do you do when the defensive end are getting pressure? You set up the screen and look at the house. Beautifully it was concealed by the Tennessee team. And finally, Washington, who made 119 tackles last year, brings it back. That looks like that was piled on, Keith.
Might have been. Didn't take long. The flag came out immediately, and you see there was an official right there, and it's going against the Bruins.
Man for distance. Nope, just
5 yard face mask.
Yeah,
penalty.
Face mask. That's
defense,
what
defense. First down.
Inadvertent face mask on the tackle. And now Tennessee has the ball. It is just outside the 10. It is not really first and goal.
About 2 inches. Yeah. They could make a first down on the 1-inch line and have 4 more downs. But this is a tough place to score from. A team like Tennessee, the defensive field has shrunk. Very little yardage to cover.
Davis and Henderson in the backfield. Robinson checking around here and changing things. And there's a flag there. Somebody moved. There was collision in the trenches. I don't know whether it was Waller, the middle guard. He got an early start, whether he was started by movement on the Tennessee line. I'll let the men in the striped shirts who get paid for it make that decision.
Keith, it looked to me like that the center snapped the ball once Waller jumped the neutral zone. That's a smart play by the center, Tennessee hyper. What it appeared to be. Boy, that was a big play and a bad, terrible mistake. UCLA to make it this time.
Yeah, that was Todd Kirk in
that
there.
That ball foul. Offside. Defense. First down.
Some schools teach their son up. Once the defense jump in the neutral zone, if you snap the ball, you get a 5-yard penalty.
Different critter right now, though. Instead of first and 10 plus 2 inches, it's first and 5 plus 2 inches.
Changing the play again. Changing the play.
On the throw. Pass intended for McGee. McGee turned to the outside. The ball went over the other shoulder. It's incomplete.
This type of offense, Keith, when you split that wide and the defense do not move many people out, you've got to throw the ball. That's what's wrong with this offense inside the 10. You really don't have any assault type of running game. When you have first and 5, you ought to be able to stick it in the end zone with, what, 1 3/4 yards per try.
Tennessee's got 12 men out there.
One's got to come off. Good count.
Charles Wilson, Keith Davis went in. Wilson didn't come out. Now Charles runs off just in time. And it's second down and goal from the 5.
Roll the quarterback out.
Big throwback hits inside the 5, close to the 4, and a penalty flag.
Looked like that when Robinson went to a long snap count.
Yep, I think Waller jumped.
Yep.
Waller jumped.
When you change the snap count on the goal line, the defense are all fired up, ready to shoot that gap, get some penetration. You go to a long count, watch the bottom of your screen. Waller, the nose guard, just jumps right there very clearly, and then this ball is snapped by the center, catching him off sides. There's Johnny Majors. Keith, Johnny Majors was the most decorated college player to ever become a successful head coach. Run up in the Heisman Trophy in 1956 to Paul Horning. A very
dead
persistent
ball foul. Offside defense.
When Johnny worked for me, Keith, he was a perfectionist in everything that he did. Still is.
UCLA's been flagged 5 times for 28 yards. And now Tennessee's looking at second down and goal. The ball at the Bruin, 3.
And they're in their goal line offense now. All the blockers are in tight.
Oh, look at this. Davis is hit behind the line of scrimmage. A great effort. I thought it was Jarecki, 99. It came flying in there to get a piece of it.
It was. Jarecki came clean inside the end and made the play and threw Tennessee back.
Lost a yard. So it's 3rd and goal from the 4.
If you're going to throw the ball in this area, you have to, most of the time, cross your receivers or roll your quarterback out. Some type of
running attack right here looks pretty pathetic. There's no socking, is it?
No, not when you throw the ball this much.
Robinson gets
away. Now he's got a man wide open. Touchdown. Tim Hendricks, and here's 90,000 happy folk. Puts his name in the book. He makes that first catch pay off, doesn't he? Junior from DeSoto, Texas. The extra point try is good. Well, we're back where we started.
Absolutely. Keith Robinson's athletic ability is what made this play. Up at the top of your screen, the quarterback, number three, Washington, looked like he had him for a loss, but Robinson's quickness gets him outside, gives him plenty of time. From the end zone, we'll watch. Washington number three is a great athlete right there, diving for him, but he couldn't pull Robinson down. Now he has plenty of time. Smith, number 98, had no chance, and Hendricks makes his first reception for a touchdown. The tight end fakes the block. Watch him go down on his knees like he's going to block. This is legal for him to block right there. Then he comes up. Linebackers have played the run all the way, wide open for the touchdown. Hendrick, Rutledge, number 30, had no chance.
So it's a 10-10 tie with 3 minutes and 35 seconds to play in the first half. Garibaldi and Green deep, and Revesz to kick off. He's going to get out of it all right, because it bounces along rather slowly, and Gaston Green picks it up. And Green brings the ball across the 20 to about the 22. There UCLA will start. That's the halftime program for you. One of the great bands in America, Dr. Julian's, prior to the Southland Band, University of Tennessee.
Keith, 90-some-odd thousand people here every week. You know, it's the thing to do in North Tennessee is come see the Volunteers play, and that band has a lot to do with it.
Yes, they do. First down, Bruins from the 22. Far and Green in the backfield behind Matt Stevens. Matt rolls it out, loops his pass to the sideline. Good to Durrell. Durrell is brought down at about the 31, close to a first down, maybe a yard short.
Here's Robinson talking to his coaches upstairs. Walt Harris is the offensive coordinator, coached at Illinois, on the Mike White. What a career this young man has had. Started just last year for the first time as a junior.
Second and one for the Bruins.
Tennessee's not in the goal line short yardage defense. It got burned earlier.
They pop it up the middle and get their first down out to about the 34 with Mel Farr carrying the ball.
UCLA continues to mix up and be unpredictable on first down between a run and a pass, and that just diminishes your ability to defend against them. The Tennessee defense cannot call their defenses with any degree of success. They don't know what to do.
They go double wide now, sending Durrell and Chouard to the top of the picture. Both teams, two timeouts, 2.5 minutes to go first half. 10-10 tie. Stevens, roll out, has a protector, gets his pass off, has a man. And the catch is made. They're going to rule that a good one. It was Sherrard sliding down and catching the low ball.
Sherrard, number 82, is just going out and hooking up on the boundary where the Tennessee defenders. Well, it's hard to cover everything, so you spot the team a short pass in the boundary, hoping that it's incomplete or you make the tackle for the short game.
Ball comes to the 39, second down, four. Paco Craig and Willie Anderson are the wide receivers now. And give it to Gaston Green, Green to the 40.
Good defense by the Tennessee team.
If they are so inexperienced, they are gaining with every play, I suspect. Green now, with that big 72-yard run, has 100 yards on 10 carries and a touchdown.
Picking up on what you said about the Tennessee defense, Ken Donahue is a great coach, believes in fundamentals and intensity. Chase that football. Success he had at Alabama was phenomenal.
Terrell and Suard come back now as the wide people, and Stevens will throw. Going deep with it for Suard, and it's intercepted at the 30 by Chris White.
Tennessee is a catch-up football team. They scored a lot of touchdowns with less than 2 minutes on the clock last year. Robinson can put them in there. He gets a good hot hand. Here, Sherrod just out-jumped for the football.
Chris White.
Chris White came across the scene. I think that's wonderful. Chris White had not played anything but special teams before this year. Moved in the starting in the lineup for the first time because Davis, the regular free safety, was injured. They threw three great plays. And a senior, Keith, that's what's great for a youngster to stay out this long, get the chance to play, and finally it comes.
Better take some more grease.
Okay.
Timeout called. Minute and 37 seconds to go in the first half. A 10-10 tie. Tennessee's. They've got one timeout remaining. A minute and 37 seconds to play. Robinson back to throw. Got a man open. That is Tim McGee. How does he do it? He and Sherrod are incredible. They're always open.
Robinson had to throw the ball before the final cut was made by McGee. He's trailing the wide receiver, and he breaks down. The ball's already on its way. Gives McGee a chance to catch it and get out of bounds. No way to cover that. Perfect execution.
And it's a first down at midfield for the Volunteers. A minute 31 to go in the first half. Robinson back, mentally flagged down. Tony going for the bundle. Incomplete. Just barely. The receiver, Flinkscale's got a hand on it, but he couldn't catch it, and let's see about the flag.
Well, Keith, while we're talking about the flag, McGee was wide open again on the same play. He could have called another 15-yarder.
Encroachment, I believe, on the Bruins.
Change of the snap count, the rusher jumped the neutral zone.
Might have been Batchkoff, the left tackle. There's your final score. Michigan defeats Notre Dame 20-12.
Live ball foul, offside, defense, first down.
Yeah, UCLA was offside, so we will be next week at 3 Eastern time in Columbia, South Carolina, with the Gamecocks and the Wolverines. That will be our game next week. That might be a pretty good ruckus.
Oh, yes. Joe Morrison has done a magnificent job at South Carolina. Bo Schembechler knows how to coach.
First down and 5, and Robinson taking his time. Got a man! McGee again. He's got a first down. He's out of bounds at the UCLA 22.
Keith, I don't want to get complicated, but the flood on the boundary is really hurting. 3 receivers, 1 deep, and McGee breaking in behind the deep receiver. Well, we're going to see that McGee is going to trail the wide receiver, number 23, Swanson. Now you can see how wide open he is. The linebacker doesn't dare drop that deep. 4 receptions, 105 yards. Right into the boundary. Seldom do you see that.
They're moving in a hurry. You've got a minute 19 to go. We started this possession with 1:37 to play in the first half.
That's moving the ball, Keith.
McGee's out here on the bottom of the picture. Robinson has some time. Goes for McGee again. Incomplete, too high. He was in front of Chucky Miller that time. As much time as Tony had, it looked like he wanted to say to McGee, go back inside. There's nobody there. And there wasn't. There wasn't a white shirt anywhere.
Well, we got a minute 13 left, Keith, and they brought the ball from about the 30-yard line to
29
to the 22.
And it's second down and 10.
In less than 30 seconds. Boy, they can move it down. 24 seconds they moved it that far. Catch the ball, step out of bounds.
Robinson dropping back and banging right up the middle to get him was Terry Toomey, the middle guard. So that's the third tackle that Toomey has made in this first half.
One thing that Robinson doesn't want to do, they're going to take their timeout.
No, are they?
Yeah, that's a mistake too.
They got one. That's zero timeouts remaining. Now here's a look at UCLA in Westwood.
Roll it in.
I don't like old Mo. He's fickle. He's going to run it. Up the middle, Wilson. And he's short of the first down, but he has the football square in front of the goalposts at the 16-yard line. And in comes Carlos Rivez.
And they've got to get the playoff without a timeout.
They get the field. It's 30 seconds.
Well, they don't have quite that much on the 25-second clock, but
49-yarder for Rivez earlier. This is a 33-yarder. And it's good. So the Tennessee Volunteers, with 16 seconds to go in the first half, move out to a 13-10 lead over the UCLA Bruins. The Bruins jumped out 7-0 on a 72-yard run by Gaston Green. John Lee, a 39-yard field goal. It was 10-0 UCLA after a quarter. Rivez hit a 49-yarder to make it 10-3. Hendricks ran it in, caught a pass, rather, from Robinson to make it 10-10. And now Rivez has kicked a 33-yard field goal. And Tennessee is on top by three. Well, this is the eighth time these teams have played. They've had seven games. Excepting for one, when UCLA shut them out 13-0, they have all been like this, up and down the field. But Tommy Prothro got so mad the first time they played in Memphis, he said he was never going to come back to his native state. But Bob Woodruff and J.D. Morgan knew what they were doing when they scheduled this one. It's been a great series. They're 3-3-1 in the seven games played.
That was a tremendous drive, poise, and Robinson had done this three or four times last year, pulled them out from behind the fourth quarter in a similar fashion. Just has that knack of scrambling and throwing. He's got a rifle arm and he's very active.
The kickoff on the ground, bouncing around, trying to force an up man to take it, and they do. Number 15, Danny Thompson, the fullback, picks it up, runs the ball up to about the 31-yard line. Now, let's have a look at UT Knoxville.
Certainly in your chosen field.
Bruins come up. They're on 31-yard line. First down. Matt Stevens gives the ball off to the up man, Mel Farr. And Mel Rambles carries the ball across midfield, and a Bruin first down with 4 seconds remaining. Once the chains are placed, the clock will start. I think probably they were, did they spend a timeout now? Maybe they want to take a timeout, see what they can cook up. They have one remaining, and since we were short-circuited out of the campus in Tennessee, let's go back to it. Midfield, first down, UCLA. 4 seconds to go, first half. Matt Stevens loads it up and lets it fly. It's intercepted. And brought back to the 25, that's Chris White's second interception of the first half. And that flattened out in the second quarter. Tennessee got a hit of steam. We'll see what happens. The Volunteers will get the ball first here in the second half. The kick goes to Panusco, 2 yards deep in the end zone, and Peach coming out with it. And he comes out to about the 18-yard line, maybe the 19, before they bring him down. UCLA's defensive front is Batchkoff, tackle. Frank is 245. Toomey, the middle guard, had a big first half, 230-pound sophomore. Mark Whalen is 6'5 and 250, a fifth-year senior. Melvin Jackson, the linebacker, 6'3, 225. Eric Smith, 6'3, 220. Steve Jarecki, 6'2, 215. And Tommy Taylor, the young man from Chattanooga, 6'1 and 235. Here's the first snap of the second half from the 19-yard line. Goes to the fullback, Henderson. 1 yard, that's all. The offensive alignment for Tennessee is the same that started the ball game. Chucky Miller is a cornerback, left cornerback for UCLA, and Darrell Henley is the other corner. They're both right at 5'9". Strong safety is Craig Rutledge, 6 feet, 185, and James Washington, the free safety, 6'1 and 195. Second down and 9, Tennessee from the 20. And Robinson comes out throwing, having trouble finding somebody right now, and then breaks it out of there. And he's got his first down as he slides on up to about the 32-33. So Robinson again gets him off the hook. There's your offensive alignment that started the ball game, and that's the same group in there right now.
If your defense just does all they can do, they cover, they get a good rush, but the ability of Robinson breaks up the middle and makes the first down run, demoralizing to your defense.
Picked up 12 yards on the carry. 13-10, Tennessee leads. As we start the second half of play, Keith Jackson, Frank Broyles, and Tim Brandt with you. And here's a long looping pass downfield. That is caught by number 87, Clink Scales, and he scores.
Keith, did it look like you? He pushed off a little bit.
Certainly did. He put James Washington in the cheap seats and got away with it.
The official was right there. And what it looked from this vantage point.
He was trying to get back to the ball, and Washington was sort of blocking his way, and perhaps that entered into the judgment. But whatever, you'll see it on the replay. 68-yard touchdown, and Tennessee out. About to make it 20-10 if they can kick the extra point.
The old momentum has turned, as we can see by the fans, the gait of the Tennessee team coming out of the huddle. Everything about them is picked up.
Randy Sanders puts down the snap, and Revesz kicks it through and makes it 20-10 Tennessee. So a shocker to start the third quarter. It was Gaston Green's 72-yard sprint for a touchdown. That was the shocker in the first quarter. Now let's have another look. And watch the power of Robinson's arm here.
Right, Key. Plus, he has to scramble. But he realizes he's got a man pretty much open. There you can see Clinkscale just pushed Washington completely all the way off, just as we saw earlier. And then Clinkscale, with his breakaway speed, goes in. Joey Clinkscale, number 87.
It's kind of like society. It's the caught from the underpass.
Well, the ball is underthrown. Sometimes the receiver has the best chance on an underthrown takeoff pattern. But right here, Clinkscale takes his right arm, then his left arm, and kind of pushes him a little bit. And then the turf shoes catch the turf really more than the push, I believe. Crew washed to the ground, and Clinkscale takes it in.
And Tennessee has scored now on four straight possessions.
Keith, once again, the scrambling ability of Robinson made the difference. He had a rush on him.
Kickoff by Revesz goes to Bob Garibaldi. And he hammers his way, and that's a fair word, out just across the 25. The Tennessee defensive unit beginning to assert itself. Robbie Scott, 275 at tackle. Red Bennett, 260 at middle guard. Mark Kovanek, 245 at tackle. Linebackers Tyrone Robinson, 6'2", 215. Dale Jones, 6'2", 220. Kelly Ziegler, 6 feet, 220. And Darren Miller, 235, and a sophomore. So it's sophomore, sophomore, junior, junior amongst the linebackers. And juniors, two sophomores in the down position. UCLA from just over the 25. Take it into the middle with Mel Farr carrying, and he picks up about 3 yards. Gary McDaniel, 5'10", 165 at one corner. The other is Victor Peppers, 5'8", 155. He, too, is a sophomore. Tommy Sims, the strong safety, the only experience, really, back there in the secondary. And Chris White, who had 2 interceptions in the first half. Second down, call it 7. Stevens gives the ball to Gaston Green, and Green with a good strong run slipping off the corner takes the football out near the 40-yard line, and it looks like it's pretty much the same unit that started the ball game for UCLA. You've got Earl Smith coming into the ball game at a tight end spot now, replacing Tunnell. No, Tunnell stays in. They go double tight. First down, Matt Stevens is checking off. And goes back to Gaston Green, who slashes over the right side, gets another first down, and almost breaks out of there and goes home. Tommy Sims hadn't grabbed him by the shirt. I believe he might have run all the way.
Here are the halftime stats. You can see that Tennessee has gained and taken over the edge in first downs and in total yardage. Turnovers is the big key. Last two passes that Stevens has thrown intercepted. They had 3 to Tennessee's 1.
Yeah, but one of them was sort of that Hail Mary into the end zone.
That's right.
Didn't mean anything.
penalties have meant something, though, Keith.
Yes, they have.
Kept the Tennessee drive going.
Marcus Greenwood is the fullback now, has the ball. Marcus, 5'11", 210, a junior out of Bakersfield. And on the first down carry, gets about three, close to 4 yards out of it. UCLA's averaging close to 7.5 yards each rushing play. Tennessee, on the other hand, about 2.5, but Tennessee has been whipping them with the pass and the scrambling ability of Tony Robinson.
This Tennessee defense has played much better than I'm sure that they had anticipated with as much inexperience as they have, but they're tackling good, Keith.
It's Green again. Now the UCLA ground game asserting itself as Gaston Green goes for another Bruin first down, getting about 7 yards on that carry. Tennessee out to a 20-10 lead off that 68-yard pass play from Robinson.
Clink Scales,
who caught it. Believe it or not, it's cool enough in the third quarter to put your coat on. That's football.
They are chewing them up with that ground game. Offensive line of UCLA is doing a great job blocking.
Inside play again. Greenwood almost pops out of there. Number 54, Dale Jones, got a piece of him and knocked him off balance. But still, the big guy picks up. Oh, you see, he goes all the way down to the 25, so he's got 8 yards.
It's just an assault type of offense, running straight at him, pitching off and cutting back from the tailback. Offensive line deserving the credit, controlling that neutral zone.
Second down, two.
Changing the play. One week.
Green, Cole, left side, and gets the first down. So they are really just blowing them out of there. I think the attendance reflected there is a direct tribute to Bob Woodruff, because he's the man that started building here, the quality of the programs, and of course Bob Nealand and many, many others contributed to the legend of Tennessee football. But they fill it up mostly every week. Del Farr is back in at fullback. Green again, outside he goes. Boy, they're getting 7 yards off that first down carry every time, Frank.
Dale Jones, number 54, was outside linebacker, is going to just chase. Good defensive players, when they see a chance, the ball carrier going the other way, don't let up. You never know when you're going to figure into play. Take a good chase angle, and he does. 105 tackles last year.
Still got 7 yards out of it. He's got 148 yards, Green does, on 15 carries. Green again. And close to the first down. He's going to be down around the 8-yard line, and that should be a first down. First and goal for UCLA.
Well, that UCLA offensive line of Hartmeyer at left guard, Cox at left tackle, Goble at center, McCullough at right guard, and Warnick at right tackle, all a 6'5 or better, 250 to 60 pounds, are doing a great job of controlling the line.
First and goal from the 8. UCLA's ball.
Somebody move, Keith, and when they blow it that early, most of the time it's the offense, unless the defense made contact.
Against the Bruins.
Yeah, they offensive linemen run it on a quick count. One thing that Homer Smith, the offensive coordinator, does with his offense, they either run on a quick count or a delayed count. They alternate it to try to confuse the defense. The right of the screen, you see the left tackle, Cox, number 72, jumping off, ahead of the count. Couldn't wait. Anxious to get after the Tennessee defense.
So the ball comes back to about the 13, where it's first down and goal from there. Reston Green. Green trying to cut back, can't do it. There's a good defensive play. Who was that? Number 14, it was. Kerry Brown. Cornerback on that side, wouldn't let him outside, came back and whacked him down.
Keith, you mentioned the cornerback, number 14, supporting on the sweep is the key to stopping that play. The cornerback has got to come up like a linebacker and turn it inside, and he did perfectly.
Green has been the motor in this drive. Second down and goal.
Not a pass.
From the 11, and they give it to Green again, and he dives back to about the original line of scrimmage, where it'll be third down and goal. So Guest and Green in this drive has carried 2, 4, 6, 8 times for 58 yards.
Keith, the coaches will tell you that when your team starts to drive and gets snapping the ball over 10 times, it sure increases the possibility of a mistake by the offense. That's what happened. UCLA got offside, a 5-yard penalty. That's put them in the hole. As Stevens, 9 for 16, 2 interceptions. He's got to throw here.
Third and goal from the Tennessee 8. Gets it away, and it's intercepted. Intercepted at the 3-yard line by Victor Puckers.
The rush on Stevens made him throw the ball poorly. Darnell is out in the open, but the ball is underthrown. Interception stops the drive. Score 20-10, Tennessee.
Right, Tennessee's got to protect the ball. Let's see if they let Robinson have his way down here, if they run everything out of there, as they go to the big fullback Henderson. And Sam booms his way out to about the 6-yard line. As Bo Jackson's totals for the day, impressive. And Auburn had a game on their hands today, winning by 11. LSU had to come late to get that one. Big day for Wickersham and Hilliard. And Penn State beat Temple by 2. It is second down and 7 now, with Jim Miller in at the fullback spot. And Robinson looks up to throw it. Nobody to throw it to, and Tony eats it back on the 5.
Boy, that Chucky Miller, number 37, had done a great job on Swanson, the wide receiver. He couldn't get away from him.
Nope.
Couldn't get away from him. Disrupt that pattern. The quarterback raises up, throw quick. Don't back up if you're the defensive back. You know he's got to throw it quick.
Now William Howard comes into the ball game, replacing Miller at fullback. BYU beating up on the Huskies. And Oregon might be the spoiler in that Pac-10 this year. Third down and about 8. Pop it out of there with Charles Wilson. Wilson comes out to the 14, and he may have a first down. Boy, he had a hole behind that right guard, Bruin, and Hibbett, the center, and he's got a first down.
When the defensive people get busy trying to rush the passer and contain someone like Robinson, they're subject to being blocked. And they got cross-blocked on that last play, and as Keith said, a big hole.
And now at the 14. Robinson wants to throw. Done. Pass is thrown to the outside. Screen for Clink Scales. And Clink Scales will move the ball out for another first down to about the 26-yard line.
When you got an arm like Robinson and you got receivers that can run and after they catch the ball, throw the ball close to the line of scrimmage. Give them a chance to pick up those blockers. Good, safe pattern. You see the 2 or 3 blockers out in front of him, and Clink Scales comes close to juking one of the, I guess that was Miller, 37, going all the way. Those are good calls, Keith. Right on the line of scrimmage. Those short passes, keeping the ball.
Robinson now 18 out of 25, 302 yards, 2 touchdowns.
Come on, defense! Get away!
Blitz.
And it's Wilson tripped up at the line of scrimmage. Number 95, Mark Whalen, got a piece of him as he went by. And he goes down for a loss of a yard.
Our old alma mater came through with a big win, Georgia Tech.
Georgia. And Kansas, record performance at North Seth is a throwing machine out there.
Kansas is a dark horse.
Come on, Kansas!
Had a bunch of players. What did they lose? 7 players?
7 by academic ineligibility, but they're going ahead full speed.
Second down, 11. Robinson down the middle. Open for the first down at the 41-yard line. Yeah, Eric Swanson.
Robinson really took a shot. He stayed in there knowing that he's going to take that shot, and he throws that ball. He waits to the very last minute. He gets hit hard. But the ball is right on target. Swanson, junior college transfer from California, came in last year, had a good season as a pass receiver. Look how he jumps and cradles that ball. Let's see if he protects it. Goes down for the reception.
41-yard line, first down. Pitch out. Charles Wilson up to the 44, picked up three. I'll tell you what, Frank. It might be gut check time for UCLA, because if Tennessee does take that thing 97 yards, whoa.
Well, UCLA doesn't have, they have a catch-up offense, but nothing like Tennessee has with Robinson. It'd be hard for them to score two touchdowns on them and not have Tennessee score anymore if Tennessee can put another one on the board. Take three scores with them.
Second down, seven. Inside, Henderson carries.
Might have got to run a little bit, Keith.
Now, Toomey, number 40, middle guard, stepped in his path and took away all of his momentum.
In come the dime defense of UCLA. Situation substitute, very popular in college today. They're trying to do a better job of defending against the pass with six defensive backs in the lineup.
It's third down and five for the ball. Davis, 190-pound freshman from Nashville, booms for the first down to the UCLA 43.
Once again, the defense widened out to get a good pass rush. That's the first thing on their mind. What are we going to do about Robinson? What are we going to do about Robinson? You better watch out for the run occasionally, because the scouts up in the box have picked up what UCLA are doing on third down and have called twice a run off tackle and made the yardage.
So he went from his own 46 down to the UCLA 43. That is the longest Tennessee run of the ball game. And the Vols have it first down. Robinson on first down gets some heat. Gets it away. And it is incomplete. So he didn't want to get sacked, didn't want to waste it, so he threw it away. Now, Jim.
Kyle reminds us who beat Northwestern last week.
Duke. Second down and 10. 43. Robinson whips it. Good. And it'll be a first down at about the 29 to Jeff Smith.
Keith, that was a tremendous throw. Robinson was just on his haunches. His arm is so strong. Right there, he sees the receiver over to the right, hits him right over the numbers, right in the belt where it can't be intercepted. Took a careful throw. Everything perfect.
Craig Rutledge jumped up on top of him, rode him down. He's big buffalo. He wasn't big enough to take him on head up.
There's Robinson, number 10.
Throw it again. Quickly to the sidelines to Swanson. And Swanson's inside the 20 and out of bounds at the 16. And that's another Tennessee first down.
The Tennessee offense is picking this UCLA defense apart. And this defense at UCLA did a great job against Robbie Bosco last week at Brick Young.
He got a Bruin hurt on the play. It is James Washington who had made the last tackle, and James comes up limping a little bit. Trainer out to check him, and I think he'll leave the ball game. Four Tennessee receivers now have four catches in the ball game. So Tony's keeping everybody happy.
Well, not only that, but keeping them happy. But the main thing is, Keith, he is identifying the defense and going to the open receiver. And he's getting, it won't be long. He'll be approaching 400 yards, if not over 400 yards. The way he's going, 21 out of 29.
First down, UCLA 16. Contact in the middle. Contact made by Jim Waller on the center, Todd Kirk. And if it, in fact, is against Waller, that'll be the third time that middle guard's been flagged.
Once again, Robinson very wisely to slow down the pass rush of the opponents. You use a long snap count one time and then a very quick count the next, and the defense cannot get the jump. It gives the offensive lineman a chance to get set and protect the passer.
UCLA's
offside defense.
UCLA has been flagged 8 times for 43 yards. University of Tennessee, no flags.
That's a big difference. Mistakes are a facet of the game of football, but you try to eliminate those silly penalties of offside at least.
It's a split crew, too. On first and five, gives it away to Wilson. Big hole, and a penalty flag goes down as Wilson gets to the 2-yard line. And look out, Tennessee may have just inherited its first flag.
Well, that umpire threw that flag 15 feet in the air. Makes you think he wanted to call it. On Tennessee,
I guess.
Yeah, that's too bad, folks. Had a great drive going. Just so many plays you can execute in college or in pro football. I was amazed last week that San Francisco, the world's champion, had 7 turnovers, Keith.
It'll be a 10-yard hole, folks.
So it happens at all level.
10 yards, going to back them up.
That isn't going to slow this Robinson down unless UCLA gets some rush. But the big thing to me that I have not seen in many quarterbacks in my time, the strong arm that Robinson has,
holding,
plus the quick
10-yard penalty. Offense, repeat the down. First down.
Keith, when you combine the rifle arm and the quick feet and the vision that he has, he knows where the receivers are. He's gone to the right man virtually every time, the open receiver. That's a trait that you see very seldom in any quarterback.
Washington is back in after a cramp. Keith Davis and Jim Miller, the setbacks. It is Davis. And this time he is caught behind the line of scrimmage by Tommy Taylor, inside linebacker.
You don't hear much about the linebackers making plays against Tennessee offense, Keith, because it's all east and west and Fulham and a trap here and there and mostly passes. Taylor's been averaging 10, 11 tackles a ball game. This doesn't get the involvement. They spread them out. Collectively, they're not as good as individually, not as good as they are collectively.
Second down, and it's close to 16 yards. Ball just inside the 22 of UCLA. Little lead pass thrown out to Smith, and Smith is caught from behind and run down by Chance Johnson, outside linebacker there. He's a redshirt freshman from Compton. And so they'll be looking at third and long. Third down, 12.
The tight end Smith just breaks in the flat, and the ball is right there, perfectly thrown by Robinson. He doesn't back up, he just raises up right the line of scrimmage and hits him, and if Chance does not make the tackle, it's a touchdown. As UCLA was in the blitz, man-for-man coverage.
It's a pretty heads-up play by that redshirt freshman.
It certainly was. He made a great play that he didn't make the tackle. He's one step behind. It's all he could do.
Run it. Davis gets inside the 15, down to about the 14. The ball's right in front of the goalposts. And here comes Carlos Revis.
It's a good play, third and real long. You want to be sure and get something. You've moved the length of the field. Where to start? On the 3-yard line, Keith?
Yep.
Moved all the way down. It's just hard to kick it all the way, take it all the way in without some mistakes. The old law of percentages comes to haunt you before you can get it across the goal line.
Carlos Revis, a junior from Miami, transferred here from UT Chattanooga, has kicked the 49-yarder and the 33-yarder, and the third quarter time expires. We'll be back for the fourth quarter after this message and a word from our local station. Ball is put down by Sanders, and he's got it. So it's quite a debut for the younger of the Revis brothers as he has kicked them good from 49, 33, and 31. Tennessee held the ball for the last 8 minutes of the third quarter. Behind 10 to nothing in the first quarter, Tennessee has scored on 5 straight possessions. And we're in the fourth quarter. 14-5-6 to play, and it's 23-10 Volunteers. And Revis kicks off high all the way across the field where it is taken and out of bounds at the 21 by Danny Thompson. Then he made the catch, but momentum carried him out of bounds.
As we look at the stats, Tennessee with 19 first downs, that's sensational. Look at the passing yards by Robinson, the total yards 425, the big play turnovers by UCLA, and UCLA has not been using their great receivers. Sherrod has not caught a pass, I don't believe, since the first quarter.
Stevens is in there at quarterback. That stays in. From the 21, first down. Farr and Green behind him, and Stevens comes out throwing. Whips it down the middle, and the pass is almost intercepted. Almost by Chris White. That would have been his third of the ball game. Michigan beating Notre Dame today, 20-12, and that sets up our game for next week. Undefeated South Carolina Gamecocks, ranked 11th in the nation, against the Wolverines of Michigan. It'll be in Columbia, and we'll be on the air at 3 o'clock Eastern time. Second down and 10 for the Bruins on their 21. They really have shut the door on Sherrard. They run it with Green, and he dives to about the 27. Well, they had that long drive in which Green was such a force that the offensive line, as you pointed out, just blowing Tennessee out of the way. Then they had the mistake down here, the 5-yard movement penalty.
Yep.
And then the pass was intercepted, and Tennessee held the ball for 8:08 and got a field goal to make it a 13-point lead. That'll take a little wind out of your sails.
Yes, it turns that momentum and all of that emotion right on Tennessee's side.
Third and a long four. They'll go for Sherrard, and it's too high. Incomplete.
It was deflected, Keith, by the lineman.
Now Jim Lampley. In the punt, Ted Henderson, 30, 44, and 41 on his three previous kicks. And Tim McGee stands back at his 31, waiting for him. He's kicking into the wind. It's high and hanging. And coming up for a fair catch all the way at the 42-yard line is Tim McGee. 31-yard punt, Tennessee with a ball, 13-point lead and good field position. Well, they are happy in Balltown. Ball Navy came in full force in bright sunshine this morning. Tennessee River runs right down behind the stadium here. A lot of folks come by boat like they do at the University of Washington in Seattle. Wander over to the stadium. From the 42, Robinson ruling it left. Throws it downfield, got a man open, McGee, and he's down at the 20.
How he found McGee running to his left, just unbelievable vision by Robinson. McGee goes down and then back out up the sideline, and he just gets lost when Robinson scrambles. The distorted secondary has no idea, no clue where to cover the receivers, and McGee is wide open.
McGee has 5 catches for 142 yards, and I haven't seen a better quarterback performance in some time.
How about Doug Flutie? He reminds me a lot of such a dominant player.
Robinson's not having to come from behind in a terribly dramatic fashion. He was down 10-0, but this is a pretty good performance.
It is. Same thing that Doug did.
To the corner! No, out of bounds. It was McGee again, and Tim caught the ball, but he was flying through space and landed out of bounds.
Tony Robinson is from Leon High School in Tallahassee, which has produced a lot of great passes, including Jimmy Jordan, who played at Florida State. He came to Tennessee, and Johnny Majors told me I wanted to redshirt him his freshman year, but he's afraid he'd quit. And he only threw 50 passes in his first 2 years, but 253 his junior year, and he's starting off in a fantastic, sensational fashion.
Second down and 10 from the UCLA 20. Throwing again. Dives this time and does not get back to the line of scrimmage. They bring him down around the 21. It's Melvin Jackson made the tackle. And let's join Tim for a moment.
All right, Keith, you know the Tennessee offense has been making the big plays all day. There's no question that was expected. But the big credit today has to go to Ken Donahue, the defensive coach. He came in this year from Alabama, and what a job he's done. It was an unknown commodity. They didn't think they had the players that had the God-given talent. But these players all day have been playing and running to the football and being aggressive and making the big plays. You know, I know one time he said that half of playing defense is wanting to. These players down here on Tennessee today want to, and the defense and Ken Donahue have been the story.
Robinson gives the ball to Wilson. Wilson is caught for a yard loss, but it's right in front of
the goal.
Right, Keith. That's the key. They want to get 3 points. A 13 lead to get beat with two touchdowns and two extra points. 16 points, if they're successful, means you have to score twice and go for two on both occasions and make it just a tie.
Yeah, but how good is this Rivers now? He's kicked three in a row.
He's taken the limelight away because of the opportunities from John Lee, the UCLA kicker.
This will be from 40 yards. Wynn's at his back. Wynn will help him a little bit.
He got it.
So he has kicked 49, 33, 31, and 40. And the Tennessee Volunteers have moved out to a 26-10 lead with 11:57 to play. Well, the 94,370 folk, about 370 of them are UCLA boosters. The other 94,000, I think, belong to Tennessee. And their team is sitting on a 16-point lead right now. It's a little surprising to me, frankly.
It is to me, Keith. Also, Ron Zook is the defensive backfield coach, and Johnny Majors tells me that he's one of the brightest young men he's ever had. His defensive backs, inexperienced, have just played great.
Bad kick by Carlos Rivers. It goes out of bounds up around the 11-yard line, so that'll back him up 5 yards. He's got the wind at his back now. All he has to do is time it right and unload on it, and he'll get it way downfield. ABC's Monday Night Football presentation, NFL next Monday night, will be Pittsburgh and Cleveland. Steelers opened with a lot of points, and they go against the Cleveland Browns. That is in the AFC Central. And then on Thursday night, we've got the NFC Central for you. The Chicago Bears, who won their opener, and the Minnesota Vikings, who shocked San Francisco with a win in the opener. Kind of nice to have Bud back coaching.
It certainly is. One of my favorite friends played for Bud Grant for 6 years, and thinks there's no finer person than Bud Grant, and what a great coach he is.
I guess you could only catch so many fish, huh?
Yeah, and Minnesota beat the 49ers in that first game of Grant coming back, his return, his comeback from the last week. 28.
This time Rivers gets it, all of it, knocks it into the end zone a yard deep to Bob Garibaldi. And comes out to the 22. Again, Jim. We've got an injured player down on the field. In at quarterback, and to run this offensive series will be David Norrie. But we've got a timeout for an injured UCLA player. Taking a lick. Daddy was heavyweight champion. All right. David Norrie is in for his first snap of the ball game on first down from about the 22. And David back to throw. Gets it away to the sideline. Sherrard makes the catch for a first down up around the 42-yard line. Norrie, 6'5", 210, fifth-year senior from Portland, Oregon. Here's Tim.
Keith, you mentioned that Ken Norton, the son of the former heavyweight champ Ken Norton, was injured on that play. They're working on his hip. It looks like a hip pointer, and he's really in a lot of pain. You know how that is. That could keep you out a while, but he is a sophomore inside linebacker. His expectations here at UCLA are high. He's going to be a good one, I think. Gets that from his dad. You're right.
Hate to see that hip pointer, though. That's a painful injury. 41-yard line. First down. Norrie gives the ball away. No, keeps it. Whips it sidearm to the sideline. The pass is completed. Up at the 46 to Al Wilson, number 88.
David Norrie was the third-team quarterback last year for UCLA. Had 7 completions out of 17 attempts, 1 interception, and no touchdowns. He's only thrown 19 passes in his career, 42% completion average. Last week, he was 6 out of 11, but only for 29 yards.
It's second down and 4. Picked up 6 on that play. Run for it with Green. Gaston Green has that faculty for slashing for the extra yard and gets the first down. Here's Jim.
Lavelle Edwards is some offensive coach. What a great record he's made at Brigham Young.
Kind of beat himself, too, against UCLA with 5 turnovers. Here's again Norrie looping that ball to the sidelines to Durrell, and now he's moving the Bruins in a hurry. You've got 10 minutes and 41 seconds to play in the football game. They're down by 16 points. They have a first down at the Tennessee 36.
Tennessee continues to stay in a running defense, single coverage their receivers and giving them the little short pass, and Nora has been right on target on three successive attempts, making the first downs. Now they have a double coverage on the receivers.
Going big for it. And it is thrown too far, incomplete. Pass is intended for number 81, Derek Tunnell, and Dale Jones, outside linebacker, trying to stay with him. Did a good enough job, certainly.
There's Johnny Majors, All-American at Tennessee. I was coaching at Georgia Tech when they defeated us in that great battle in Atlanta, 6-0, went on to have an undefeated season. All-American on everybody's team. Coached for me for a few years, and he was a perfectionist as a coach, just like he was as a player.
Second and 10 for UCLA. Norris straight back. He gets some pressure on him. He gets it out here. The pass is caught by the fullback, Mel Farr. But Farr is just buried well short of the line of scrimmage. And here's Tim again.
I have an update for you on Ken Norton, Jr. It is not a hip corner. I just talked to the doctors. They said he took a pretty vicious shot to the side, but they really feel he's going to be okay. Now they don't suspect the hip corner. That's good news. I'm sure Dad's watching back home.
The loss is back to the 44 of Tennessee. Well, that's a loss of 8 yards.
One of the shortcomings of Norrie, the quarterback, he's not very agile. Doesn't have any foot speed to really dodge the rush.
Third and about 18. Intercepted by Chris White, his third of the day. White's got some help coming back upfield. All the way to the 39.
Keith, that ball wasn't even spiraling. Looked like he was twirling through the air. Well, what happened? How about the substitute, White, who has three interceptions? Only plays he'd made was on the special teams before today.
So Tennessee owns the football, first down at their own 39, leading 26-10. UCLA, unless they have some real thunder and lightning here, going to go 1-1 on opening successively on the road. They have San Diego State at home September 21 and open the conference September 28 at Seattle against Washington. Tennessee gives the ball to Davis. Davis is thrown down right at the 40 for a yard pickup. Tennessee will take a week off now and get ready for Auburn. The Tigers are coming into Knoxville on September 28th. That'll open the SEC play for those two teams. And the way it looks right now, that could be a whale of a football game. Woo.
Well, that should be a great game with Bo Jackson on one side, who's a potential Heisman Trophy winner. And who can discount the performance of Tony Robinson today? If he'd keep this up, he's got to be a Heisman Trophy candidate. We could have one of the most exciting games. We could do that with, oh boy.
Start Bobby. Break it up the middle. The fullback, Jim Miller, a junior from Nashville, brought down by Terry Toomey. First down falls. The ball comes down. And see where they've marked it. Down at the 47 of UCLA. Here's Tim.
All right, Keith, we were talking about that defensive spirit down here on the Tennessee sideline. One of the truly great stories has to be the senior defensive back, Chris White. In his first start, three interceptions, and of course it was the injury to Charles Davis that allowed him to get that start today. He wasn't even sure prior to the game if he would start, but he comes in, three interceptions, the whole team now rallying behind him. You can see him gathering as the coach talks to the defense. He indeed has been some incentive to this rubber band defense that has stretched but will not let him score and break it.
Yeah, got to have a Walter Mitty every Saturday.
Well, it's great that it happened to a senior who had just played on the special teams and not really had a significant role in this team, but today he's the hero, along with many other Tennessee players.
Well, you know, the marvelous thing about college football is a day like this. Now, whether Chris White ever plays a day after he leaves Tennessee, he has had a day to remember, and people are going to remember Chris White, and it'll be something that'll last him the rest of his life. That's the wonder and marvel of college football to me. On the ground, pounding away with it, is Charles Wilson,
And Tennessee now would love to run the ball as much as possible to keep that clock moving.
And stay in the huddle as long as they possibly can without getting a penalty. But back to Charles White, Keith. Johnny May just does what most of us do, I'm sure, is give the team ball to some player who had a significant role in the victory. And I would just wager that Charles White will Chris White will get that ball autographed by all of his teammates who put in his den for the rest of his life.
Third down and 6.5. Tony Robinson shoots it over the middle, and it is short of the first down. And making the catch is Charles Wilson, but making the hit is James Washington for UCLA. And so it'll bring up a fourth down. Timeout is called, stopping the clock now with 6 minutes and 52 seconds to play in the game. Well, Smokey, the blue tick hound mascot, satisfied with the way things are, so he's having a nap. It is fourth down, 2 yards plus, and they're going for it.
Oh, they're just going to try to draw them all, Keith. Plenty of them. Yard penalty and then punt the ball. It's academic to 5 yards.
Yeah. They sat there for a good 30 seconds and eyeballed each other and nobody moved. Now in comes Garmon to do the punting. Garmon has punted only one time today. One time.
Well, this is the first possession that Tennessee hasn't scored on in six. Six consecutive unanswered scores by the Tennessee Volunteers. A little bit different style of play than what we used to see in Tennessee with the old single wing.
Gifford Irvin is deep for UCLA.
Block is on, Keith.
Going after Tennessee.
Best chance.
Gets it out. That when everything's going right, you just don't worry about it. Just ride the roll, and they have killed the ball inside the five. Down, literally. Well, they're going to mark it out a little bit from the goal line by out to about the three.
But UCLA safety
was somebody really hustled down there to get that ball out of the end zone, keep it from going in.
Then about three of them, yeah, 25 is going to really. And he's close to the goal line there.
The first man, I couldn't see his number. Well, UCLA is 97 yards away from the Tennessee goal line, trailing by 16 points, 6:38 to play. And David Norrie is in at quarterback. Throws to Durrell and misses far. Through behind him. South Carolina, Michigan, from Columbia. We'll have about 75,000 folks in Columbia next week. And they are wound up about their football team down there now.
I guess Mike Holt is the starting quarterback this year for South Carolina.
Yeah, he's still rotating, isn't he?
Is he? Uh-huh. With Mitchell and Holt. Joe Morrison, he's turned that program around as fast and quick as anybody that's been in college football.
Second down and 10 from their three. Norrie out of his end zone. Goes down the middle with it, and the pass is too high. Girard got a hand on it, could not haul it down. Again, Jim. Third and 10. Tough operating down there with 94,000 folks on it. Norrie lets it go. Girard in a foot race and a great catch by Girard. He had two people there and he pulled the ball down. Chris White and Victor Peppers were with him, but he just went higher.
Girard is such a great receiver. Concentration. He just runs along at the last minute at the proper time. He goes up and catches the ball. Peppers, number 8, just couldn't stay with him. And White was coming across, number 7. But Chiron had that body control and came down with it.
5 catches for Mike, 95 yards. First down, UCLA, out of the shotgun now. Snap from their own 48.
pass thrown to the sidelines and incomplete, the penalty flag, and you may have interference call here. With that force of yours, you're going to be a non-factor when the Hogs play the Rebels tonight, I can tell you that.
Well, I'm looking forward to being there tonight in Jackson, Mississippi. I'll be yelling either way. Well, I can or can't. So, Sherrod has had such a fantastic career at UCLA. 48 receptions in 83, 43 receptions.
Jim Welch is the man that gets flagged here for Tennessee.
Sherrod just goes down and breaks out.
Oh, it's Anderson.
Willie Anderson, yes. And the back, Welch, makes contact before the ball is there, interfering with the ability to with the opportunity to catch the ball.
Out of the shotgun on first down from the Tennessee 41. Norrie takes off up the middle and picks up a first down. His advance will be to the 30. There's a penalty flag. It's going against Tennessee, and that's going to help the Bruins. You've got 5:55 to play, 26-10 Tennessee leads. But I would never go past the old Yogiism. Ain't over till it's over.
Oh boy. Well, Tennessee's getting a few bad breaks now late in the ball game. Seems that's the way it goes sometimes. You get a big lead, the mistakes start making mistakes.
5-yard face mask penalty defense.
Moves the ball to the 25, where it's first down, UCLA. Gaston Green. At about 4.
Excellent pursuit by the Tennessee defense.
Montreal defeats the New York Mets 5-1. Mets boot the ball 4 times. Palmer beats Fernandez. And St. Louis in the ninth over Chicago. So the Cardinals will pick up a game if they hold on to the win. I'm into the lead. Second down, 6. Norrie, real good protection. Now he has to run out of it. And struggles to about the 17, 18, make it the 18.
No huddle. The signal offense that that Tim Brandt talked about before the ball game. Now timeout. Tennessee.
Well, I would imagine the Tennessee defense wants to talk. They have been so strong for 2.5 quarters, and now they've grown a little permissive. Third down for UCLA and 3 yards for the first down. Gaston Green has the first down. And he's inside the 10, close to the 8, before they finally put him on the ground. Lavoisier Fisher and Dale Jones finally wrestle him down. Green now, 180 yards, his career high running, marked by the 72-yard touchdown sprint. Kickoff returns for 46. He had a pretty good day himself.
He's a brilliant young runner, just a sophomore. Has that speed, the balance, the power, moves, does it all, as those numbers reflect.
Ball at the 8. Crowd is not helping Dave Norrie. Keeps it. Looks down into the end zone. Touchdown for UCLA to Al Wilson.
UCLA will have to go for 2. Wilson, number 88, will break all the way across the middle. And the defensive secondary leaves him alone. One's playing man. And the other defensive back is playing zone. When you cross at the goal line, you give the defense a chance to make a mistake, and that's what happened.
So let's get the 2. Get the 2.
Well, if they make 2, it'll be 26-18, and then if they can get the ball back and score and make 2 again, making 2 successive 2-point conversions, odds are not good.
In college, for the season, for every Division 1, 2, and 3 team, is about 40%.
Successively.
He's open.
He's got it.
busted defense by the
Tennessee. They went to sleep on that corner, and Jeff Nowinski, the tight end, pulls in the two-point conversion pass, and that's what you've got now, an eight-point difference in the ball game.
Look how wide open he is. Somebody really busted their assignment.
Or wouldn't it be the left corner?
Left corner should have stayed back on the fake. He can't be up there tackling the run. He's got to play pass first.
4:46 to play in the game. And still a lot of time. Jim? Well now.
Will they try an onside kick? Or will they take the chance on their defense stopping? Well, it's still 4:46. I'd kick it down
the field.
Yep, try to kick it over the end zone. Start them on the 20. Make the defense.
They kick it high. It's not too deep. Goes back to McGee at the 6.
He didn't win. Well, Keith, what he did, he's afraid he might fumble the ball, and so he just puts his knee on the ground. No chance to fumble. I don't know why that his reaction was that way, but he said to himself, if I get hit, I may fumble. I don't want to do that. So he put his knee on the ground, killed the ball before the contact.
At the 13-yard line, though.
Well, we used to do that on the last 15 seconds. We've intercepted a pass. We'd say, don't run with that ball late in the game. Put your knee on the ground, then run with it.
Yeah, but you got 4:42 to play in this one.
And McGee's a good runner, and I'm a little surprised that he did that.
Robinson comes up 24 out of 33 for 381 yards, his career high, and two touchdowns. And he's got it, and he's going to throw it. No, he's not. He's going to run it. And he dives across the 20 and gets out to the 21.
Robinson has broke containment of the outside defense of UCLA virtually every time, Keith. That's amazing that he can just get outside of that containment and then run a throw, whichever he chooses. There is numbers, 72% completion, nearly 73.
The ball is actually almost touching the 20. It's just over the 20. So it's second down and close to 3. It off to Wilson. No, not Wilson, Davis. And Davis does not get the first down.
You can be assured that in the huddle, they have cautioned the backs to protect that football. As we look at the defense, the staff of Tennessee.
Yeah, but if they don't make it on third and a long one here, they got to give UCLA back the ball with 3.5 minutes to play.
And a very young defense, and UCLA came from behind in the last 2 minutes, moving 82 yards to beat Brigham Young. So they believe that they can do it. Confidence.
We got Miller in there at fullback. They give it to Wilson, and Wilson's got the first down.
Biggest play of the ball game so far, right there. It was a big play to keep the ball away from UCLA. Good
block. Watch this hit here. Watch the tackle now at the end of this tackle by Washington.
Washington is from that breed that they say like Easley and Rogers.
You didn't have a shiver?
That's a great tackle. He's tough. 119 stops last year as a freshman.
Wasn't what I asked you.
Oh.
Wasn't that a shiver?
A shiver with
threw
a...
that right upside the head.
That can be a penalty. You cannot tackle with your arm.
It was the elbow in the ear that was the bother. Ball is tipped in the air, and Robinson comes over and knocks it down. That thing could have been picked off. In fact, there was a UCLA man in the neighborhood. Melvin Jackson tipped it up, and Tony Robinson, realizing it might have been intercepted, knocked the thing on the ground.
Well, that's the presence of mind of a senior, young man who's been back there in that pocket a lot of times. The receiver's open, but the defender knocks it up in the air. Now, watch this. This is something.
Yeah, but Batchkoff is going right for it.
He's dunking it. He's dunking it right there. He didn't want it. Might fumble if he'd caught it. Did the smart thing.
Yeah, that 245-pounder with red eyes coming at him, too. He would have taken some punishment.
That does stop the clock. Incomplete pass stops the clock. Something that Tennessee doesn't really want to do if they keep from it.
Second down and 10.
Bill changed the play at the line. Numbers game.
Davis. Good blocking on the left side, but good reaction by the UCLA backers, and Melvin Jackson and James Washington come up to get him in a hurry.
Washington came close to stripping the ball right out of his hands. He went for the ball, which is what you're supposed to do at this late stage of the ball game. Washington put his headgear and his arm right on it, but couldn't knock it loose.
2:20 and counting. Third down and 7, Tennessee. Just beyond their own 32. Third and 7.
Will they throw?
I think they will.
Bootleg it out of there.
Give it off to the tailback, Wilson. And Wilson is decked at the 34, and you're looking at fourth and long now. And Tennessee's going to have to punt. UCLA stops the clock, stopping it at 1:53 to play in the game. Timeouts remaining. UCLA has 1. Tennessee has 2. And Tennessee has an 8-point lead. In comes the punter, Garmin. Deep goes Gifford Urban for UCLA. 1:53 to play.
Lock is on by UCLA.
Joel Farmer snaps it. Good snap. Kick is away. Urban at the 25. Down at the 27. Joel Farmer, the man who snapped it, the man who makes the tackle. It was a 40-yard punt by Garmin and a 1-yard return.
Now the Tennessee defense got to make up their mind. They don't want to play a prevent, but they don't want to give the easy touchdown either. With Sherrod, Tunnell, and Durrell, three great receivers, UCLA are forever dangerous.
Dale Jones, the linebacker, trying to get the crowd into it, waving his arms and, come on, make some noise. 94, almost 95,000 of you. And out of the shotgun, Dave Norrie drops to throw it. Dumps it off to Gaston Green out of the backfield, and he can't get it down. Ball was thrown behind him a little bit. I don't know if Tony Robinson will see the ball anymore today, but if he does, he's got a chance to beat Bobby Scott's record set back in 1970. Robinson has 381 yards total offense today. He is just 4 short of Bobby Scott's record.
Dewey Warren was the quarterback for Tennessee in that 37 and 34 game. He had a fantastic game, similar to what Tony Robinson did today.
Swamp Rat's an assistant coach up at Swanee.
Oh, is he? Yeah.
This time, the ball is delivered to Gaston Green, where he can catch it, and he does catch it for about 8 yards, maybe 7. They marked him at the 33.
Tennessee's trying to keep the quarterback in the pocket, rushing from the outside, keeping two men up the middle, trying to put a little pressure on him.
Making a 6-yard pickup, third down and 4. Third and 4. They give it to Primus. And Primus is knocked out of bounds, close. The chains are all the way across the field. And yeah, they're going to bring him across, I think, here.
Oh, he makes the
he's
first
close.
Down.
Yeah. I think he's got it.
Yeah, he's got it.
Yeah, he does. Tennessee now has called, I thought they'd called a timeout, but I guess not. So they still have 2. UCLA with 1. Time remaining, 1 minute, 26 seconds. 26-18 score. Norrie going under center, rolls this one out, gets the pressure, sack him. Hey, throws the ball, a pass is caught. How about that? The big guy from Portland, Oregon was on his way down and saw a man and threw the ball to Mike Sherrard, and Sherrard made the catch close to a first down. Dale Jones had a hold of him and had him on the way down. Look at this.
The quarterbacks are taught to throw that ball if they can, anything to avoid the loss. That's something they work on every day. But look at that one-handed catch by Sherrard. He makes a nice gain out of it.
They're going to bring the chains in. They want to know exactly how far they have to go. They do not have the first down, but they want to know precisely how much they need.
With one timeout left, they don't really need to be running the football at all.
Well, he needs, what, a half a yard?
Half a yard. This is the college football scoreboard coming up next. This is just what UCLA did last week. Coming from behind in the last 2 minutes to win the ball game. So they believe they can do it. There's a confidence level out there. You can see it.
second down, half a yard. They've got Green and Greenwood in the lineup. They're going to waste a lot of time on one here. If they run it, they pop it big, and they're going to run it. Well, they're going to run it pretty well.
Get out of bounds.
Gaston Green blows it over the left side and goes down to about the Tennessee 41 and gets out of bounds, killing the clock with 1:01 to play.
Last week, it looked like it was impossible for UCLA to beat Brigham Young. They were trailing with 2 minutes to play. Got the ball on their own 18-yard line. They scored and won the game.
Well, they played a 17-17 tie here one time in Knoxville. Because I did it. I remember.
Tennessee is not lined up properly. They have a hard time getting adjusted. Now they're in good shape.
Norris still got it.
He missed the handoff, Keith.
And he's going to go out of bounds. Knocked out back around the 46.
He had an off-tackle play called and just couldn't get to Green on the handoff and had to keep it. I don't know how the blocking was. I didn't see, but there's the score. 8 points from a tie and the time, 54 seconds.
Loss on the play from the 41 back to the 46.
Back to the shotgun.
Second down and 15. Across the field, Sherrard got it, out of bounds. And that was first down at the 27 of Tennessee.
There's an old saying, threading the needle. And that's exactly what happens here. As Dory throws the ball right in between the defenders, in front of one, behind the other, and inside of the third man. Three of them around Sherrard, they couldn't get to it.
Sherrard now 7 catches, 124 yards. 49 seconds to play. First down. Just inside the 27.
Here's the blitz.
Give it a Green. Through the 25. 2 yards. Victor Peppers, the right corner, came up to support on that side and did the job. And you've got timeout called by UCLA. That is their last one. You have 43 seconds to play.
Lots of hustle, that's our repeat. That's why he's eating what the big boys eat. Loved his Wheaties since he was small. Now dig in, big boy, have a ball. Classic hit of crunchy wheat. Pure and simple, not too sweet. Dive right into those Wheaties feet. Now go tell your mama what the big boys eat.
That's a big step, Tom.
I'm still gonna go to college, Dad, but after the Army.
I thought you wanted to be an electrical engineer.
I'll be learning about electronics, and I can qualify for the new GI Bill and new Army College Fund.
If you qualify, the new GI Bill and new Army College Fund can help you save over $25,000 for tuition.
So you're gonna be a soldier?
Yeah.
Be all that you can be.
And an engineer.
Find your future.
Be a good one.
In the Army.
That picture tells you everything. And the home crowd is getting all over UCLA here, making it as tough as possible. Now they force Norry into his hand signals. And out of the shotgun, goes for the corner. Touchdown! Sherrard! Willie Anderson, 83, made the catch. Can you believe it? With 37 seconds to play. And here comes your two-point play for a tie.
Last time, Tennessee busted their defense, and it was an easy, easy, successful pass for the 2 points.
Willie Anderson, 83, comes up with the biggest catch of his life in the corner of the end zone over Victor Peppers. And here comes the two-point play for the tie. They give it to Gaston Green. He's in there. They run the ball and tie it up at 26-26.
There's not much you can say except give tremendous credit to that UCLA team for not giving up, putting forth the effort. They did it last week, and they've done it again. Here's the touchdown. Anderson just runs a fly pattern. Tennessee was trying to blitz, had man-for-man coverage. Peppers, number 8, is beaten by one step, and the ball is right on target. Here's another view from behind the quarterback. Takes a perfect throw. Peppers, number 8, is in pretty good position. Just one step. And Anderson, number 83, just goes up, plays his body, hands, coordination, eye contact, everything. Now the two-point conversion.
And this was a surprise call to me.
Well, Sherrod wasn't in the ball game, so you should kind of get the idea that maybe they were going to run the ball. The blocking was there. Fullback making the key block on the quarterback, but the speed of Green takes it in for the two-point play.
So when Tennessee seemingly had it in hand, 26-10 in the fourth quarter, the Bruins have come bang-bang for two touchdowns and successive two-point conversions, and the crowd of 94,000 is quiet. The 370 Bruin rooters are loud. And here's the kickoff by Bray. Kicks it deep. Why not the onside kick here? The return comes out to about the 22-yard line by Pete Panuska.
Well, anything can happen, Keith. I've seen it all, really. Two timeouts for Tennessee. 30 seconds. Let's see what Robinson can do. If he had about a minute and a half,
you
be
have
tough.
A problem.
Yeah.
With Revis in the range, and Revis would have the wind at his back. He would have the wind at his back. UCLA now is going to go into deep contain. But Georgia got burned on that deep prevent, didn't they?
Yes, they did. We've seen some comebacks this year.
No, they're not in that deep contain either. They're right up there. Now you got one man dropping deep, Washington. And Tony Robinson back to throw it. Gets away from one, pulls it down, takes off to the sidelines, and gets a first down.
It's according to where they mark it.
Depends on the mark.
They hadn't stopped the clock yet. They're letting the clock run.
Nope, not a first down.
Well, they got the measure. I think they called it. Nope, Tennessee took the timeout.
Well, they got ran it all the way down to 18 seconds. Now they're going to measure. They need to hit one big pass to get him in range. Now, I don't frankly know what his range is. He's hit one from 49 today, and he hit that one from 49 into the wind. Now, you might give him a shot at a 55-yarder, and with the help of the wind, who knows?
Well, he was kicking before the game 55-yarders, nearly up to 60. I was watching him.
Tennessee has one timeout remaining. It's a 60-minute game, isn't it, Coach?
Yes, it is. College football. The passing game, Keith, has revolutionized and made everything pretty even in college. Anybody can win on any given day.
The flags show the wind going the other way, but they were blowing that way yesterday afternoon, but the flags are going to the right, but the wind whirling around in this huge bowl is going to the left. But that's down the road. Right now, Tony Robinson and company have 18 seconds to get the ball down within some reasonable range for the field goal try. One of the great comebacks you'll ever see by UCLA. And Tennessee seemingly had it in hand. Robinson under pressure, gets it away and throws it away. Didn't have anybody. And Tim McGee, I'll guarantee you, drew a crowd that time.
I'd be watching Tim McGee with about two, maybe three men on him. As Robinson.
11 seconds to play.
That pass took 7 seconds, so he's got to hit something down that middle or deep on the boundary and step out of bounds. UCLA is not playing a victory defense. They're up there playing their regular defense that they played all game.
Pass is caught. Player tumbles out of bounds. That's Wilson out of the backfield.
That stopped it.
That stopped it.
No, it didn't stop it.
Didn't stop it. Didn't you knock him out of bounds?
Game's over.
Looks like it.
Game's over. They rule him down. He did not stop the clock as he went to the turf, and the game is over. Sort of an anticlimactic way to end the ball game, perhaps. But UCLA down 26-10 in the fourth quarter comes storming back with two touchdowns.